Hey, how about these tail lights? I just yanked them off a trailer. They should pass DOT, right? Another episode here at Gasoline Garage. Did a lot of random little projects here. So I start here in the back end. Did some brake lines. Good old rubber lines from the 80s were just a little bit dry rotted. They kind of crumbled in some spots. And yeah, a little yank and they came right off. Took them off, had the fittings and new lines pressed together and made for me. Sorry about the rain. But that's what we get here in Florida when hurricanes come. The lines, the brake lines, actually had my guys down at Silliman Hydraulic do them for me over by Sarasota Airport. Awesome dudes. They really specialize in a lot of hoses, fittings, hydraulic pumps, rebuilds, and etc. They work on equipment there, and obviously it's really nice being able to bring things in and have them usually do them right there or same day. It's nice having brakes. Look at that leaf pack. You'll see something later on the leaf pack. But yeah, after I got this brake line in, the backs and the fronts as well, you'd be surprised how it stops compared to not having the rears or the fronts working very good. Big old honking muffler. You'll see that come out a little later. That kid pool came in handy. Well, a couple days later, we had some sunshine. Another picture here of the leaf pack. I ended up yanking all those out except for a few. I ended up dropping it. The back came down, I believe it was about four and a half inches or so. Had some U-bolts made and also relocated the battery box. It was a little farther back there on the frame bolted in. Took the box, cut off what I wanted to keep, welded it up, welded it to the under the step, redid the power lines and grounds, sprayed some of the anti-corrosion on there. Also yanked out the injectors, trying to figure out this smoking problem I had still. Thought replacing the injectors would help. Also finished the intake. I almost forgot about that. The 5-inch tube I got in some fittings. Was able to get a cone filter on there, and not sure how I'm going to mount it yet or if I'm going to make a bracket of some type to hold it up there. I just threw a hose clamp on there for now. A few measurements I did on the front wheel spacing, and this is before I took out some leaves in the front, that is. And then after. So it came down about 2.5, 3 inches in the front. And then in the back, it came down about, I don't remember what it was. I should have measured it. It was about 4, 4.5 or so. You'll see the tire gap in there. So yeah, this is before I yanked out the leaf pack. So I think there was probably about 6 or so leaves there. And now I have 2, I believe. I have a long one and kind of a medium one. So this is before, and then you see the tire gap, and then there's after. If you notice something else in the picture, you'll see that towards the end, so stay tuned. I still had that rat smell inside and couldn't figure it out. Had a couple little holes here I started to weld up. And there it is, a rat nest right in the heater box. I decided to end up taking the whole heater box out. It's Florida. Rarely use heat here, so I'll figure out what I'll do later for air conditioning. Dynamat project began. I dynamatted the whole floor. A couple pieces on the back, which I don't have done here yet. And I did the from the front to back. Nice stuff. It's rubberized. It's sticky. Used a roller. Put it down. Didn't have to use any heat. Just trimmed out around, you know, the shifter and the emergency brake, the pedals, the steering column that goes through the firewall. And it's pretty solid now. It sounds, you know, instead of that tinny noise when you tap it, it's pretty solid. So that should help out with some noise in the cab. Not sure what I'm going to do in the doors yet. I did spray a little bit of rubberized coating in there after this. Probably end up getting, when I get the windows out, I'll reach up in there and see if I can get some dynamat in there. It'll make the doors nice and solid too. Another picture here from the driver's side. obviously burning the midnight hour. Enjoy this stuff so I can go all night doing it. Did the headliner too with a little different type of insulation. It's a little thicker rubber mat. Started my exhaust, so I was able to use my original downpipes from the manifold there and welded on some fittings. Big old muffler that I yanked out of there probably weighed about 100 pounds. I still got the smoking issue here. You'll see this is before I took the leaf packs out there, so don't kill me on that one. We're jumping around a little bit. But and also this is before I had the dynamat in there too. So I jumping around here a little bit, but still smokes like crazy when I first started up. And this is obviously after I got the new injectors in there. Yeah, I still got to figure that out, what's going on. Almost sounds like it's missing. High-tech exhaust hanger there. Should hold up, right? That was just temporary. I ended up getting some metal ones and welding them. And I threw in some 5-inch stacks. Did a little 45 there and used the flex piece down underneath and clamped them all up. Ended up using some black paint there with the flappers. I really like the flappers. Brings back my childhood memories, seeing trucks going down the road. Well, stay tuned. Working on episode 3 here, so hopefully have another one here with some more updates. I'm working away.